I had the pleasure to interview filmmaker artist Steven Eastwood, who closed Into That Good Night, a 5 years program of art dealing with death and dying, commissioned by Fabrica. Steven spent a year filming an hospice in the Isle of Wight and produced on the top of the multi-screen installation The Interval and the Instant, opening on the 7th of October at Fabrica, a feature film, Island, premiere at the London Film Festival this week and coming to Brighton towards the end of the exhibition.
One of the things I wanted to ask was, what kind of images do we have of death and dying? What kind of images do we think we're not allowed to have or aren't appropriate? And how we might look at that, people who are dying don't tend to be visible. And that's partly because we think that we shouldn't be looking. And actually, in my experience, working with and meeting and getting to know people who are nearing the end of their lives, they wanted an image, they wanted to be participants in culture like everybody else. Was able to film at the invitation of several people in extraordinary circumstances, including one person who I became very good friends with, who said he would like me to be with him when he died, and I was. Essentially, I feel empowered by the experiences I had, and I hope that the work here at Fabrica and the feature film can sort of pass on some of that feeling of empowerment. I think a lot of people get very nervous. They get nervous about art and film that's about death, and they get nervous about death in their personal lives. And of course, that's understandable. But when people, I hope, see the work, I don't think it's as frightening or as troubling as you might think. I think it could be uplifting. And death is very natural. You know, why are we so scared of something that is as natural as being born? So I came to know, over the period of filming, four people in particular. And two of them invited me to be in the room with them as their lives were ending. In the case of Alan, he very early on in our relationship said, I think that you would like to stay with me and I think that would be okay. I was in his bedroom in the hospice. I filmed for 36 hours without stopping. And that is an incredible record of a natural death. So there's a 36 hours of his breathing slowing until he dies. And then he is verified dead. And then his body is cared for, cleaned, and he is dressed. And all of that is featured in the artwork. The work at Fabrica is built around a three-screen triptych, which is in the main space of the gallery here, and that's three video screens that are side by side, and it's a 50-minute loop. And then we have some satellite pieces. There's a piece in the foyer called The Planets, which is images of microscopic cancer biopsies. And then in the back room, the side gallery, there are two final pieces. One is called One Day, The End of Life, and it's a five-hour piece in real time, which shows the end of Alan's life. And then the Chapel of Rest is pretty much like going to see somebody you know in a chapel of rest, except it's Alan and he's in his coffin. But I filmed for 12 months on the Isle of Wight, where this hospice, the Earl Mountbatten Hospice, is. And about halfway through filming, I realized that I had something else. And I knew that there was a feature there as well. So actually, before I finished the Fabrica piece, I cut the feature film, which is a 90-minute documentary called Island. It's interesting for me as an artist filmmaker what you can do in the cinema that you can't do in the gallery. In the cinema, I have to make very careful decisions about how I show the end of Alan's life, because at some point I have to cut. They're very different ways of looking at the same experience.
This is William Ranieri for latest TV news.